Yo, guys, welcome to the BFFs Podcast YouTube channel. Make sure you guys subscribe, like the video before it starts. Let's get into it.
All right, BFFs, we're back from the holiday break, Christmas, Hanukkah, New Year's, everything. Josh, you're back in L.A.?
Yeah, I'm back in L.A. now. Yeah. Got back Saturday.
Okay. And Brianna, where were you?
I went back to Boston, and then I went to Miami.
You were in Miami as well?
Yeah. Everyone was in Miami.
Miami was busier. I was in Miami. I saw your boy Griffin. He was in Miami. Gruen
probably
texted me. Did you just talk and I'd not hear you?
I don't know. No, no. Can you hear me?
You did like a mimic with your. It looked like your mouth moved, but nothing came out.
No. That was like 2 weeks. That was a different episode when we were doing that trick. I'm not doing that trick.
Right. Yeah. Gruen was there. Griffin was there. Gruen texted me 100 times to hang out. I just kept blowing him off. Every night. Hey, dinner here. Come to manager Miles' house here. We got a boat here. So it's like, no, 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 no. But yeah, Miami. So I've been to Miami for the Super Bowl, the Art Basel, which is like this crazy event they do there. By far the busiest I've ever seen the city.
Crazy.
Like,
yeah, I
heard that kind of goes into like these, a lot of your world. Got in trouble for theoretically going to the Bahamas.
Yeah, no, a lot of people got in shit for going.
Like the DeMellos went. Little Huddy. By the way, you know what the new thing that happens to me now? Like I had a very pretty girl walk up to me. She's like, Little Huddy's dressing there. He looks like an asshole. Like, and I start looking for Little Huddy. I'm like, am I going to get in a fight right now? And then I remember it's Little Huddy.
Yeah, it probably won't be any fighting, I would say.
No.
But, no, yeah, I saw like...
Your microphone, by the way, is like sideways, I think. Like, yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah.
There were like 12 different creators getting posted about going to different places and getting like kind of shit on for it. Like pretty intensely.
You know who was the number one shitter?
Who?
Nessa.
No way she's shitting on people the most. I saw like one story.
Nessa Barrett. Happy New Year, everyone. As we're going to 2021, I hope and pray a lot of you selfish fucks out there will wear your masks and social distance. It's almost embarrassing to see so many people party, travel, and disrespect simple safety rules. I hope we can all wake up this year and start living out of love and sympathy for others rather than only caring about ourselves. She's coming for our throat, Brianna.
She's coming for our throat, like hard.
I think, fair enough. That's all I'm going to say. Fair enough. I thought that was an aight story.
I mean,
I expected it. Like you expected that shit when you travel, right?
No one
now,
gave
right?
me shit.
Yeah,
but Nessa did, yeah. But no one else. What'd you do? Did you just stay locked in your house?
No, we had a crazy lockdown in Canada, so I was pretty much in my house the entire. I actually quarantined for 14 days at the start, and then after that, I finally started to go out, and then Canada went into lockdown 3 days after my quarantine was over. So I didn't really do much.
So what's the Nessa response video that we have here? What is this? Can we see it?
And what is she responding to? Is this another COVID thing?
I think she's just like Fauci Jr.
She is not fucking with people that travel during COVID.
No, where does she live?
She lives in LA. I mean, she's been in LA for like the last 11 months, just like kind of in her apartment.
Oh, all the ignorant and selfish people out there that are partying and traveling and simply just not social distancing because of you idiot fucks. People are losing their lives and their jobs, and you are just out here simply making a mockery out of the global pandemic that's going on right now. Oh, that I was one of those idiot fucks during the beginning of COVID, but then I saw how it was affecting innocent lives and innocent families and how it even affected my family back home in New Jersey. And I grew the fuck up and started being selfless and started caring about other people and followed simple safety precautions during the pandemic.
So what do you have to say for yourself, Brianna?
Yeah, Brianna.
I mean, I wasn't an idiot partying fuck. I was laying on a beach.
But yeah, how'd you get there?
Took a plane with a mask on.
I'm going to say this. Paul, who's here, my friend.
Yeah.
We went out 7 straight fucking nights. I mean, if I'm telling the truth here, what I did in Miami was from 9 a.m. to like 8 p.m. I saved small businesses. I did all that, which is catching steam and is a great cause. And then
yeah, I saw that.
From like 9 p.m. to like 6 a.m. I did a ton of drugs and partied like for 7 straight days.
I mean, that's a lit 7 days.
It
six
was
days.
Fucking lit. I'm going back tonight. Done.
Oh, you're still going?
Yeah. I got back here in New York. It was snowing. I'm like, get me the fuck out of here. I only came back to do this. That's dedication to the craft. It's like we hadn't done it in 2 weeks, and I wanted to look good and have a good episode, so I didn't want to half-ass it, so I flew back.
Nice.
I'm going the fuck back there.
I mean, Nessa might make another video and call you an idiot fuck. I'm just saying.
We're going
to
have
to
get
ready for
on.
That. She might actually have to come on to let you know how much of an idiot fuck you are.
To light my ass up. I mean, listen, COVID's sure. totally real in a real thing. I don't doubt that. I'm not making light of it. But it doesn't, first of all, I've had it. So I have twice. Right. So I've had the antibodies. But if you are worried about it, you do NASA and you stay in. And if you're older yeah. or health impaired, stay in. Vaccines around the corner. But you got to let people live at this point is my opinion. And everyone's entitled to their own.
Right. I agree that everyone's entitled to their own opinion. So it's just like, I've just been staying home because I know that
Nessa will rip your guts out. That's why.
Yeah. Yeah. Nessa will slap the shit out of me. So I can't do that.
Wasn't she out on Halloween?
No, we never went out. We got dressed up together and then we came to this like Bryce's house and it was just like the Sway Boys and their girlfriends.
Last thing on this point. Michael Gruen said he's trying to get me to move to L.A. I mean, to Miami. And he said, direct quote, I want to move to Miami. I think, Dave, if you move to Miami, Josh will move to Miami.
Oh, so are you moving to are people moving to Miami now?
Gruen sound like he was. He's like, I'm going to Miami. L.A. sucks. And I'm telling you, if you move, that'll tip Josh. He'll follow and he'll come.
Well, L.A. does suck. I can agree with him there. It's a shitty place.
Has he told you to move yet?
He hasn't told me to. He's talked about it, though. Yeah.
Also,
he likes Miami.
Go ahead, sorry.
He loves it. He loves Miami, man. He went there this, like, last whatever Christmas break, like, with Griff. Loved it. They said it was, like, the best place ever.
You're talking this. We saw them.
Yeah,
we saw
you
them
guys saw them. Komodo. Yeah. Yeah.
And also, so weird. I was talking to Paul, who is with me. The demos you're in. Like, Griffin is fucking huge. I don't know. He's got, what, 17 million, 18? He's, like, obviously yep. huge on social media.
Oh, huge.
Massive. The star at that Komodo dinner was me. No one knew who he was because it was, like, an older 21-year-old crowd. Like, Odell Beckham was there. I was there.
Holy fuck.
Fat Joe was there. Griffin was there. It was a big crowd. I led right. the league in pictures. I got Fat Joe's cell phone. Fat Joe put his cell phone number in my cell phone.
How do you beat that?
Can't.
Terror Squad. And then I'd ask everyone, you know who Fat Joe is? Younger, they'd be like, no, who's that? I'm like, come on, Fat Joe. Do you know who Fat Joe is?
No.
I've seen Fat Joe.
Actually, would Michael have met him? Was Michael talking to me about him?
I know.
Is that possible?
We'll get the Hollywood Fix guy in a second, but we have to play a little Fat Joe right now.
Is he good? I don't know. I've never heard him before.
He's
yeah,
fucking
I don't listen
Fat
to his
Joe.
Rapping. Like, I don't listen to his rap music.
Yes, you have. Right. When you hear this song, I bet you've heard it. He's
this
fucking
Fat,
Fat
Joe
and the Terror Squad.
This is Fat Joe?
Ow! Yeah!
Okay, this is a good one.
He's got a million.
Throw your hands in the air right now, man.
Nothing, Josh?
Fearless. Right here.
Scott Storch. Maybe we gotta skip ahead a little. I don't think I remember.
I know this one.
This isn't his biggest like hit.
Well, it's not that old. Dude. That's 2009.
Play this one.
Okay, this is a bigger song. Yeah.
Nothing?
Oh, this song's great.
Oh, I know this song. Yeah, I know this song.
This show sometimes depresses me a little bit. Because, I mean, I was excited, like, and we'll get into it later. The two people who physically took my phone and put their cell phone number in it was Fat Joe and Madison Beer. I was far more excited for Fat Joe. We'll get into that other story late. We got the Hollywood right. Fix guy in here. So this is to give the background. You're going to know him. You know him, right, Josh?
And here he is. There he is.
He is the king of, like, TikTok paparazzi, right?
100%. I would say social media paparazzi.
Okay. So the TikTok guy, the Hollywood Fix guy in the house. Yo, can he hear us?
It's so early, man.
I know.
Fletcher ain't awake. Fletcher is still sleeping.
All right. So Fletcher Green.
Yes, sir.
I'm so interested in this. How would you describe yourself?
What do you mean, like, personally or my job?
Job. And then personally a little bit, like, how you got into it, the background.
I'm a paparazzi is what I do is my job. I mean, I look for, what's up, Josh, by the way?
What's up, man?
I just look for, you know, current celebrities and then try to get, you know, pictures and video of them. And then, you know, sell it to media outlets or, you know, post it on my YouTube channel. And, you know, that's just my job, you know.
Have you come, and forgive me if I'm wrong, have you come to prominence with the TikTok era?
Yeah. I mean, the TikTokers are great. You know, they're like a new wave and a new kind of style of celebrity. Your traditional celebrities, like your rock stars and movie stars and stuff like that. You know, those are great people too, but it just kind of like things change in a new era.
So were you shooting the more traditional stars before you kind of took over the TikTok landscape?
Yeah. And I still do. I mean, if they come out, I mean, I'll shoot, you know, Ben Affleck, same as that. If I see Josh, you know, I'll go see what's going on with Josh and Nessa or whoever else he's dating right now. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, it just, you know, you just kind of like expand operations. And I mean, I was doing it even before TikTok. I was shooting, you know, YouTubers and Instagram stars, you know, before that. And even before TikTok, it was like Vine. You know, I'd be shooting Vine stars before even really TikTok came about, you know.
So then my question, well, I have two questions. First of all, if you know that Josh is dating anybody, and you probably do if you're following his ass all over the place, besides Nessa, feel free to inform us right now. That would be great for the show. And two, I feel like, so I've been doing this for a long time, and I don't know if I'd say Perez Hilton a little bit early, maybe, who crossed. Like, the fact that we have you on the show to talk about it, that's pretty unusual for somebody in the paparazzi who I feel like is usually kind of faceless. So you've created your own degree of fame by following, I think, the TikTok era. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely fair to say. Yeah, I mean, like, I've been doing this now 7 years. So, you know, this isn't anything brand new to me. For me, I just feel like I'm doing my job. You know, my job is basically kind of like almost like a news reporter. You know, I'm trying to get the latest news just basically on anyone that's out. You know, I can't force people to come out that aren't out. You know what I'm saying? But if someone's out, then it's, you know, what are they doing? What are they wearing? What's, you know, just kind of capture the, you know, the moment in time of what's going on. And I haven't been shooting anything for about the past month because of the COVID, virus, and everything is shut down. So I've really just been posting other media. You know, I did a deal with Getty. So I've been posting a lot of Getty content over the past month and really completely out of the loop as far as what's been going on with TikTok for the past month. I mean, when I'm out and when I'm working, that I'm on top of it and try to stay as much as I can with the current trends and what's popular. And, you know, Josh's tea talk is always really popular. They like that, you know, and just kind of just everything that's going on within the whole, you know, social media community, period, you know, across all platforms. But, you know, TikTok has become very popular over the past year. You know, that a lot of people want to know about it.
You guys feel free to jump in. Do you ever, TikTok's so young, right? How old are you?
I am 38.
So do you ever have an internal struggle with yourself, like, uh-oh, like I'm shooting like these young kids and that's a little different than like a Ben Affleck or anything like that?
No, not at all. I mean, the thing is like that, I mean, at one time, you know, not too long ago, I was, you know, 20 something years old and, you know, and a teenager and, you know, but back then it was just different people that I was interested in and stuff like that. But I mean, it's all the same. And the base is the platform mainly starts at is that you have to have a buzz around your name and you have to have a fan base. You know, I don't just go interview any teenager or, you know what I mean? It's not just anybody, but I mean, you know, I've shot, you know, Northwest before when she was like an infant, you know what I mean? So it just, you know, or I'll shoot like Chrissy Teigen when she's out with her, you know, kids that are babies and stuff like that. So it's not, you know, it just starts with you, I guess, having a degree of fame and then it just goes from there, but it's not like I target kids or anything like that.
Well, yeah.
Right. Yeah, and I've always been, you know, pretty cool with most everybody. I think I think Bryce lost his temper one time when I asked him about Addison because he was like, "Stop asking me about Addison."
Shocking. That guy's got the shortest temper and softest skin going, so that doesn't surprise me. Someone has to tell him, and I don't mean to do it, that he's dating one of the more famous women in the world, so he may get some questions about that. So, yeah. Is there any of these guys that you don't like? Like that you're like, well, you just mentioned Bryce, but.
No, I know. I love Bryce. Bryce is awesome. I didn't mean to say that. We just kept hitting him with so many Addison questions because that's, you know, at the time, if you just looked in my DMs, you can just scroll and scroll and scroll. And it's like, find Josh, ask him about Nesca. Find Bryce, ask him about Addison. Find Chase and ask him about Charlie. And then I do it and I ask it. And then everyone goes, oh yeah, but you didn't emphasize this word strong enough. Go back and ask him again, but you know, emphasize this word. So he was just kind of burnt out about like, I've got my whole career going, you know, you don't have to just keep asking me about Addison over and over, but that's really what the fan base was really predominantly wanting to know about. So that's why, but no, I love everybody. I mean, I've never had a problem with anybody. Everybody's really great, really cool. You know, all the TikTok houses are great. And no, I mean, I love everybody. I think everybody's really cool. And, you know, I've always gotten good content and good media and good, you know, good stuff from everybody. So
are there ever influencers that hit you up to come find them, like to come film them? Like they ask you to come?
No, I wish there were. I get a lot of tips on like, say if someone's walking around Melrose, and then they might see, oh, hey, like I just saw Josh like walking down the street or so-and-so went into here, or I just saw, you know, Jake Paul just went into, you know, Barney's and stuff like that. I get tips
right
from people that see other people. And then if, I mean, occasionally if there's like an event, like say if a clothing brand is having a launch, you know what I mean? One of the PRs might say, hey, we've got an in-store appearance, but for that type of stuff, they put it on social media anyway. Like you'll see a flyer on Instagram. But
I was just wondering if people are trying to like get clout that way, you know, like if there's creators trying to like stay relevant. So they keep like asking for paparazzi people to come find them. Didn't know.
No, there's been a couple that have in the past, like once or twice, but, and it's funny because.
Yeah. I was going to say, who is it?
Name names.
Need the names.
I can't do that because I don't give out, you know what I'm saying? My sources. I don't want to really like, you know what I'm saying? Expose anyone, but there have been when people first start, they're a little bit more inclined to kind of get some traction and get their name out there. And, but then it's funny because once they start to get a little bit bigger, then they get their ego popping and then you don't hear anything from them anymore. But, you know, if somebody, you know, has something they're trying to promote or wants me to show up somewhere and I do, you know, that's fine. But then it's, you know, it's not something that frequently happens at all. It's a rare situation.
Josh, are you happy? Like, I don't want to say happy is not the right word, but if you see Fletcher, are you like, all right, this is good. Like picture, or do you just like, whatever, you're used to it.
I don't think that I necessarily start like smiling with joy. I don't mind Fletcher as a person, but it's like, paparazzi sometimes just sucks, man. Like after dinner, you know what I mean? Like I'm just trying to go home and like maybe watch Family Guy. Like I don't really need to answer questions, but it just depends on like what's going on in social media. If like everything's going good in my social media, then I'm like, I don't really care. I know they probably won't ask me anything like crazy. But if I know I'm in so much drama at the time, or I'm like, go, like, I know they're just going to keep trying to like slide, they're like sliding questions or like make me mess up on what I say or something like
that.
Isn't
it good though? Like, I guess
mean, it's
it
numbers
is
at the end of the day.
Like, if you hit a certain degree of fame, you're probably sick of it. But I feel like the level you're at,
it's like it's a good sign.
It's like if they're paying attention, that means I'm doing something, yeah. Right?
No, it's definitely a good sign because it lets me know I'm still like relevant and I'm still in the kind of, you know, people want to know what I'm doing all the time, not just like what I'm doing on TikTok. So yeah, it's a good thing. All publicity is kind of good publicity to a certain extent too. So
who's like right now the hot list? Like if Fletcher, if someone's like, hey, you can create, you can walk out the street and bump into this person, get a photo in like the TikTok world. Who's your like top people that, I don't know, Getty's or whoever would pay the most for right now?
Well, I mean, it's, the thing is it kind of, it can quickly change depending on who's got an interesting topic at that specific moment. Like I said, I haven't really shot any TikTokers in like a month now. So I'm kind of out of the loop of what's been going on with them just because of the COVID shutdown. But I mean, really the main, it's just kind of a main group that I shoot. It's kind of like the Sway House and the Hype House, and then their, I guess, affiliates. And those are kind of the main, you know, group that's always been the core group really since day one. So I mean, just pretty much, because I mean, there's a lot of people on TikTok, but it's just kind of like a almost like a little university of the one, just kind of the main core group that I shoot. And I mean, some of the newer TikTokers, you might shoot some of them, but if they don't have as big of a fan base or as, but it's almost like a small family. So it's not really like one or two. It's kind of that core group of just mainly, like, I would say the Sway House, the Hype House, and then they're, you know, if someone's hanging out with someone a lot, then they can kind of get pulled into that group. You know, I know someone that I was getting a lot of messages about, I haven't even really been checking my DMs a lot lately, but was Nye and then Vinny Hacker dating or something like that. I was getting messages about that. Then someone messaged me that, Josh, you said you were dating some girl, but then you said you didn't like her anymore or something like that. I got some messages about that, but I think you spoke about it. I can't remember the name. It started with an S or something like that.
Oh, it's the girl.
Yeah, this is Sunny. The Maloof, Sunny Maloof.
Yeah, Sunny.
Yeah. I got a message that someone saw her on a date with some guy and they were eating lunch somewhere, but it was like in the valley and I couldn't even make it in time. And they were like, oh, this is Josh's ex-girlfriend or something like that. So,
no, she probably sent it in herself to get more like streams on the song, man.
Oh, I don't know, but I didn't make it. I couldn't get it. So, but that was, you know, but that's basically it. Kind of just the core group that you just see on my YouTube channel. There's so many TikTokers that I don't know all of them, you know, but I just kind of, I mean, I started off, the first people that I shot was like, it was like Charlie and Chase and Maddie Monroe and Ivani and, who was it, like Christopher Romero, a group of them coming back from the airport. And that was the
I remember that. That was, they were in Bahamas, right? Or some shit like that. It was one of their like Bahama trips that they do.
Yeah. And so basically that I had gotten a tip from some fans of, you know, this plane's coming in. Now, when I shot that, I have absolutely no clue who these people are. I've never heard of these people a day in my life. I mean, right. I'm just sitting there like, who are these people? But after that, then there was like a meet and greet at the Grove that they posted. And I'm kind of like, okay, well, I recognize this guy and them. And, you know, it wasn't the people who I would normally shoot at all. But I mean, there was a day that, you know, I remember when Cameron Dallas first introduced me to Jake Paul. And I'm like, who the hell is this guy, Jake Paul? You know what I mean? And so it's like it all, you know, it all trickles in. And there'll be, you know, a day where Josh is hanging out with someone new and then everybody will be like, oh, who is this guy? Or you, like, y'all were hanging out with the guy Mark or something for a while.
Yeah.
And so it, you know, the things just kind of change and, you know, friendships come and go and things, you know, change. Like, say, for instance, Tony Lopez, when I first started, a lot of people were like, you know, go get Tony Lopez and wanted him a lot. And then I think he had kind of some drama. And then so, you know, that kind of changed and, you know, things come and go and people, you know, change who they hang out with. They change who they date. you know, so it can change.
Here's a question for you, not to put you on the spot, but you've shot what movie stars and things like that. So you mentioned Ben Affleck, you know, other people in LA. If we're saying who can we all agree here is like an A-list celebrity in like Hollywood? George Clooney, I saw it on this list. He's A-list, yeah, right?
Justin Bieber.
Yeah.
So in that world, where would you put Josh?
Oh, man, Josh is definitely just, it's like here's Brad Pitt and then Josh is just one step underneath. Whoa. It. You know, Brad Pitt better watch out.
That would sound good. Pretty good.
You know, I mean, what can I say?
Like, it can't be.
Dude, my phone is blowing up off the hook just nonstop, you know, with just everybody just wanting to know about Josh. So, I mean, the thing is that, you know.
Do you guys have any more questions, final questions for Fletcher?
How about Dave? How high would you put Dave versus Tom Brady? Like, if Tom Brady's pretty famous, right? Like, then where's, like, Dave?
You can answer it. Won't hurt my
feelings. Who's better, Dave or Tom Brady?
No, like in popularity level. I'm just going into the sports world.
Hi, but you know, Dave might just be one.
See, there we go. These answers, we're not getting real ones.
Hey, what do you think about Tom Brady kissing his coach guy on the lips that when they won the Super Bowl?
That's Tom Brady?
Yeah, didn't he do that? Didn't after the Super Bowl? He kisses
everyone on the lips. He kisses Sonny. That's just what they do. That's just what they do.
Okay. All right.
Well, thank you for coming on. A little look into the paparazzi world. So, Fletcher Hollywood Fix. What's your YouTube channel's? What for anyone who wants to follow it?
Yeah, just you know, subscribe to the Hollywood Fix on YouTube channel. You know, I've been posting tons of content lately, a lot of different stuff on there. You know, after, you know, Gavin Newsom lifts this ban, you know, then everything will open back up and they'll just be, the floodgates are open and tons of new content. So yeah, just go check it out, the Hollywood Fix on YouTube, and thanks for having me on, guys.
Thanks, man. Take it easy.
Yeah, thank you.
He was a people pleaser.
Yeah, pretty blah. You'd want a paparazzi guy to like sling it.
Yeah, he was right. Trying to like
throw more like drama in there.
Yeah, a little bit. But I mean, you have no problem with him, right?
No. I mean, I think also he wants to be a people pleaser because he never wants to like go and shoot a TikToker or a celebrity and then them already hate him. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah.
All right, gonna take a quick break. This show brought to you by the Lawnmower 3.0. It's by Manscaped, who is the best in men's below-the-waist grooming. Manscaped has redesigned the electric trimmer. The Manscaped engineering team spent 18 months perfecting the greatest ball hair trimmer ever created, just released the new and improved Lawnmower 3.0. Their third-generation trimmer features a cutting-edge ceramic blade to reduce grooming accidents, thanks to the advanced skin-safe technology pioneered by Manscaped. When I tell you this is premium, I mean premium, battery will last up to 90 minutes so you can take a longer shave. The waterproof technology allows you to groom in the shower. That's huge. One of the coolest features is the LED light, which illuminates grooming areas for closer and more precise trimming. They've also upgraded to a 7,000 RPM motor with quiet stroke technology. Let's not forget about the charging stand. Show your mower off loud and proud because this intelligently designed stand is convenient charging dock powered by USB. If you're listening to me speak right now, I want you to experience firsthand for yourself. Trim that junk of yours. Get 20% off free shipping with the code BFF at manscaped.com. Your balls will thank you. Get 20% off free shipping with the code BFF at manscaped.com. That's 20% off with free shipping at manscaped.com. Use code BFF. Seriously, get me one of these. Okay, back to the show. The last thing in the Sway House, which we have, your sister. How old is your sister?
She's a year younger than me.
So she made a video, people trying to use her to get to you?
That was like kind of a joke. We made those names up. That was just for like comedic purposes.
These niggas is fake, plastic. Her booty ain't big as Jurassic.
So I'm just gonna list off some names. Fuck you, Sydney. Fuck you, Ella. Fuck you, Kennedy. Yeah. And a double fuck you to Alyssa Henderson. Hit me up twice.
What's wrong with that girl? What's up, bud?
What's up?
So fake names, nothing there. Although it's probably some truth to it, no?
Oh, no. That's like, so what happened was my sister came up to me like the first night I got home. And she was like, oh, there's these girls that will like Snapchat me. that haven't Snapchatted me in so long, and they're like, yo, let's hang out, just because you got back. And then we saw a duet, like the or video at the start of that, where a girl actually made that video saying, like, I wonder how many girls have hit up his sister asking to come over. So then we just made, like, a fake video kind of thing where my sister was calling out all these names and, like, dissing on him. But there was a girl named Alyssa Henderson that was, like, from the area we lived at, I guess. And she duetted the video and just, like, posted beside it. Super funny, but.
Duets are the way to go. All right. So that, yeah, I mean, I can see that. How many times you get back to Toronto since you've kind of exploded?
That was my first time. I haven't been back for like 11 months.
Yeah, so there you go. That I can see that. So what do we got up next here? We're going to, the Miami, we're going to talk. So, still cleaning up. We said we're in Miami. Madison Beer, and I texted you this. So Paul and I were at the pool, and we saw her, like, she was pretty close to us. And obviously, we have that video where I thought she was James Charles.
Right.
So I'm always content. I'm like, all right, how do we walk up to her? And she's with some kid who looks like a skateboarder with, like, Chinese tattoos down his neck and looks super young. I think her boyfriend. Right. Which
I think. I don't know, though.
Sway House guy, right?
No. Hype House guy.
Hype House guy.
Yeah.
She said it was her boyfriend, so I'd say it's the boyfriend.
Oh, if she said it, then probably, yeah.
She said it. He looked he was 12, but he looked like a dangerous 12.
Oh, well, no. That means they're definitely dating. Because I saw another picture, like it was a paparazzi thing, and it was like, I think them loading suitcases into a car together. So it makes sense.
Yeah, so Paul and I are just, we're planning it. And it's like, I don't want to go up to her. I don't think she has any clue who we are. And it's like, hey, you're sitting there in, like, your bikini with your, like, boyfriend skater dude who looks like he's going to do an ollie on my face and your dad. And it's like, I don't want to walk up, like, older dude, be like, hey, so see this video where I say you look like James Charles? So we're going back and forth. Paul doesn't want to do it. I'm like, you have to do it. We have to do it. We just have to take ourselves out of the moment. And who cares if it's embarrassing and creepy? Right. It'll be a super funny clip. Because I want Paul to just start taping. Like, imagine her. You just walk up. Like, hey, I have this video of you. And another older bald guy is sitting there just videoing you. So it's like, how do you set the stage to do it? And we're going back and forth for literally half an hour. Like, should we go up? She gets up.
She leaves.
And comes to us. And she's like, you're Dave from Barstool, right? And I was like, yeah. And she knew all about it. She's like, I saw that video. Super funny. So me and him look like giant pussies sitting there being like, do we do it? Do we not? Super cool. Like, she was as cool as you could possibly be. She's like, I'll come on the podcast. I have a new album coming out. I think, when did she say?
February.
So she's like, I'd love to come on there. Paul still taped it. We showed her the video. She's like, yeah, you can post it if you want because we were talking about it. She was actually super chill, super nice.
No, I've met her a couple times. She's cool. She's been at the Sway House a couple times.
I didn't know she was from New York. That changes everything. But it's also somebody like her. Like, she had no makeup on, still very pretty. But, like, you know, paparazzi's always, she said she couldn't go out. She's like, yeah, I can't go out. Anywhere I go, it's just a disaster.
Right. Yeah, no, she definitely does get absolutely obliterated by paparazzi.
But yeah, that was that. The people we saw with Odell, Guy Fieri, Griffin, it was crazy. Miami was crazy. But good Madison Beer story. Didn't think she'd know who we were. Kind of blew up my ego a little bit when she knew exactly what it was in the podcast. Okay, marry, fuck, kill. Is that what we're doing now?
Yeah, marry, fuck, kill.
So you set these up, Brianna?
Yeah, these are for you and Josh.
So you know how to play this, obviously, right, Josh?
Right, it's like three people. I choose one to marry, one to fuck, one to kill.
Exactly. Yes.
Easy. Okay. Starting with Sway Boys.
Yep.
Awesome. All right. God.
I'm marrying Griffin. I like Griffin. I like you.
We have to read the names off first. So we got Jaden Hostler, Noah Beck, and Griffin Johnson.
I'm going to marry Jaden. And then I'll kiss Griffin and then kill Noah because he's with Dixie. So that's going to be my saving grace there. All right.
Yeah. I don't know. I'll fuck Jaden and I'll kill Noah, I guess. Griffin, and like I said, Griffin and I saw in Miami, he's like, I'll come on and sling it. I know Guy X is being a little bit soft, but I'll come on anytime. We should have had him on. This could have hurt his Miami experience. Is he there?
Griff's back in LA now. He's been at the house.
So is he at the house now? Oh, you're not at the house.
No, I'm not. So yeah.
Got it. Yeah, so that one's easy. He seems like an easy enough dude to bust balls and get along with. Jaden's kind of got that alternative thing, and Noah Beck seems boring.
Well, I like Noah. He's classic, all right? He's a classic guy.
It's a nice guy.
What about you, Brianna?
Oh, I don't know. I think I would marry Noah Beck because he's so nice, and then kill Griffin and fuck Jaden.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Okay, we got Jeff Bagwell, Tom Brady, and Nick Foles.
Okay. I'm killing Bagwell. Right off the start. And then...
Do you know that joke?
What?
Do you know the Bagwell joke?
I don't think I do. Is that bad?
No. I'm just deciding whether I want to tell it exactly. So I had a sex tape leaked. And he has like a super strange batting stance. It's like a crouch. And a lot of people said what I was doing looked like Jeff Bagwell. So that's why that's on there.
So Jay Alvarez uses coconut oil. You do the Bagwell.
Yeah. Coconut oil is definitely weirder.
Yeah, maybe. All right. I'll marry Brady and fuck Foles.
Yeah, I'm going to do the same.
Nice. I seen Brady give nice kisses, so I'm assuming he'd be a great husband.
Brianna, I assume everyone's going to have the same here.
That, mine would be the same, yeah.
Nice.
Okay, we have Chantel Jeffries, Father Kells, and Wolfie Cindy.
I don't know who Father Kells is, but she's fucking gorgeous.
Yeah,
she's gorgeous.
I was going to say the start of what you said. Yeah, I don't know who she is.
Holy shit, she's pretty.
Do you want to go first, Dave?
Yeah, I'm going to marry Father Kells.
All right.
Fuck Chantel Jeffries. Kill Wolf Cindy.
Yeah.
I'll marry Father Kells. Fuck Wolf Cindy and kill Chantel Jeffries.
You know the girl on the left? She went to jail for like stabbing someone.
Love it. That's the perfect girl to fuck. Wait. Crazy.
Wait. Whoa. Chantel Jeffries went to jail for stabbing somebody.
Yeah.
Who'd she stab?
I don't know. I don't know the whole story, but she stabbed someone, went to jail, and then she blew up because like. They were like all escorts in Miami.
Chantel Jeffries used to like date
back in the day, with Justin. The Austin McBroom's wife.
What?
Yeah, that's how they got started. The one in the middle is Instagram model. This one, Justin Bieber found her on Instagram and made her completely supermodel famous.
What about you? So Wolf Cindy?
Oh, me. Okay, I would fuck the stabber, marry same as you, marry girl in the middle, kill. Wolf Cindy.
The only thing about marrying Father Kells is you'd always be worried everyone's trying to steal her because she's so fucking hot, so you're just going to drive yourself nuts.
Yeah, she's perfect.
That's funny.
Okay, Tana Mojo, Madison Beer, James Charles.
Well, this is simple.
No, but it's people are going to get mad at us if we just say it's simple, Dave. You know how the internet is.
No, they're not going to be mad. I'll answer. It's like I'm not gay, so I'm not going to fuck a dude.
No, yeah. I'm going to... I don't know, man. This is a tough one for the Madison versus Tana part.
You'd marry Tana? That's crazy.
Well, I know both of them. They're both kind of like, oh, whatever. I'll marry Madison. Fuck Tana. Sorry, James. Got to murder you.
Yeah, that this one seems like wildly easy. Marry Madison, fuck Tana, kill James. No offense, James. And by the way, we have the clip. To James Charles would love the clip that we have of Madison because she was like actually sort of flattered. She's like, he looked so good in that picture, so good at makeup.
Right.
I was like, yeah, I'm down with it.
I mean,
you were down with it.
You were down with it.
Yeah, well, I thought it was her. So, yes, I was down with it.
Okay, last one. Alex Cooper, Alyssa Violet, and Stassi Baby.
Who is Stassi Baby?
Kylie Jenner's best friend with like the fattest ass ever.
This is simple. It you got in my head for a second because Cooper's there.
Yeah.
She works for me. If I married her, I'd kill her. So that can't be the case. So I can't kill her either because we need to call her daddy. So I'd have to fuck her. I'd marry Alyssa Violet and kill Stassi baby.
Okay. I'm gonna kill Stassi baby. I'll fuck Alyssa Violet and then marry Alexander Cooper.
Yeah.
Marry her?
Good luck with that. Right. Alyssa Violet is super hot. Who is that?
She's like a YouTuber. She used to date Jake Paul.
No shit.
Mm-hmm.
Is that her real name? Are these people all making up names?
Stassi baby has to be made up.
Alyssa Violet? That probably
that is sounds made up,
too.
As well. I think she dated both of the Paul brothers, actually.
Really?
Yeah. I made a diss track about it.
Yeah, they did. Who, make
what
a diss
was
track.
Your answer on that one?
I think it would have been the same as Josh's.
You'd marry Cooper.
Oh, no. Kill her because she pays my salary.
Correct.
So I'd fuck her. And then, yeah, same as yours.
Okay. All right, quick break. Slice, the official pizza delivery partner of One Bite. We want One Bite and Slice to be the only way you order pizza. We've updated the map page on the One Bite app so you can now see Slice pizza shops in your local area. Slice makes ordering pizza online easier and quicker. Only place to find the best pizza in your local area. Slice is the better deal for shops. Slice works with 14,000 local pizza shops, have saved local pizzerias $200 million in fees. Download the Slice delivery app. Use code DAVE for $3 off your first order. My voice is dying from Miami. That's fine. Twitter at Slice. Instagram at Slice. Facebook at Slice Pizza App. URL slicelife.com. Back to the show. So that's marry, fuck, kill. Interesting.
Solid
there. And then we got Boomer Zoomer. Zoomer versus Boomer. By the way, Josh, before we get into this, did you see I posted the we had a shirt, the Dixie stand, and I will get Dixie on this fucking podcast. The TikTok room, they just don't have sense of humor. Like every comment, they put this picture of me wearing the Dixie stand shirt, and every comment was like, it's so creepy that you're trying to fuck like a 16.
That's what they all were. All the comments were like, he's so fucking creepy. Let it go, Dave. You're a perv.
Get him off. Get him off TikTok. Get him out of the internet. I mean, they took it dead literal. It's insane. And then she responded like in kind, being like funny, saying, calling me for the 50th time, trying to get me on the podcast. And everyone's like, she must be so disgusted having to pick up the phone for me. What are you talking about? Who are these kids? How dumb are they?
They don't know what the real world is yet. I don't think they've ever had real life interactions. So they can't.
They have like this literal thing. Like their brain is like, they don't get sarcasm or like everything you say, they take dead literal. It's quite amazing.
It's the cancel culture.
No, it's actually crazy. Yeah. It is crazy.
All right. Zoomer versus Boomer. I'm curious to see where we go with this one.
Oh, I know him.
I think I actually know this guy. He got canceled, right?
No, that's Mr. Beast.
That's Mr. Beast?
Yeah, man.
Shit, I talked to Mr. Beast last week.
I know, he did stuff with the fund, didn't he?
Mr. Beast, first of all, I always address him. I didn't know what he looked like. I talked to him. He did. He donated 150 grand. Was it 150 grand? I think it was. And when I say, Josh, people are like, hey, ask Mr. Beast for a donation. I was like, hey, Mr. Beast. That's what I call him. And you want to talk about cucking somebody. It's like, hey, Mr. Beast, it's Dave. And he's just Mr. Beast. Anytime you got to call another person Mr. Beast, you're behind the eight ball. He donated the 150 grand within like 3 seconds. He's like, sure, I'll do it. I didn't even know who he is. He runs the internet.
Dude, he runs YouTube. Runs YouTube.
He reminded me of you a little bit. I was talking to him. So we talked on the phone. He's like, I just want to know what you do and what your story is. So I told him. And then he told me his. He's like, I studied the YouTube algorithm for like 10 years and just mastered it. He's Mr. Right. He's fucking a beast.
Mr. Absolutely. Beast. He deserves the name. He actually deserves the name.
And he's got these business plan ideas that They're are crazy. So fucking insane. And if anyone else told me them, I'd be like, dude, you're crazy. Like if someone at my company came up to me, he's got this idea of putting like a flash drive on the moon. He's putting it on the moon. And he's like, I'm going to charge people to, like, put a time capsule so you can put a picture on the moon. And when, like, Earth is wiped out or something, your picture on the moon will live. And he's like, it's going to be huge. And I was like, I got to be honest, Mr. Beast. I don't know what you're talking about, but you're fucking Mr. Beast. So I'm sure it's going to be giant.
That's a wild idea.
How do you even think of that?
Yeah, that's wild.
He's like, I rented a spot on the moon.
That's like, a what? Thing?
From who? NASA.
It's just on, like, it's rich, just on fucking rich. Zwillow. It's on Zwillow. You just type up the moon. Got a little lot.
That's what he's got.
Good to go.
A little
good
flash drive? Go. He's just going to throw it up on the moon?
He set this thing, this burger chain. He had the number one food app on, like, Mr. Beast Burgers. He created this. I didn't even understand. He was telling me it. It's like, holy shit. He's like outselling McDonald's and he's got these Mr. Beast Burgers. He's just anything he wants to do, he can do. I never heard of him.
It's unreal.
Internet's like the ocean. It's endless. Like, I think I'm like, oh, we're doing good, Barstool. And you're just little guppy fish. And here comes Mr. Beast and he just fucking eats you.
A shark.
I can't believe that's what he looks like. Mr. fucking Beast. I mean, you don't have it either.
You don't have it, Josh?
Nah.
Bruce Springsteen. Damn. Do you know who he is?
I know a song or two.
I knew the name.
Born in the USA?
Yeah. I would have never known that's what he looks like. He looks like a rock star.
He is.
Isn't he a country singer?
No, there's a song called Springsteen from a country singer.
Oh, okay. So I don't know who he is.
But that shows you how big, like, he looks like a rock star. Bruce Springsteen, E Street Band. Shit.
That's JoJo
Candy
Siwa.
Cane? I don't know.
It's JoJo Siwa.
Who is that?
She's really rich.
She's really
what
rich.
Does she, like, what did she come
like
from?
Like a $100 million hair bow company.
That's what she does?
She's a TikTok YouTuber. No, but she did dancing, like Dance Moms.
That's where she got her start.
She's not worth it. This girl,
Look it up.
What's
crazy.
Her name?
JoJo Siwa.
She sold like $100 million worth of
I think it might be
hair.
Billion.
JoJo
Ties or something.
Siwa.
Something crazy.
Net worth. $14 million. Get out of here, Brianna.
No, her bulls,
I can
though.
Buy and sell this but girl 100 times over.
No, Nickelodeon owns her.
No slave trade, but you know what I mean.
Nickelodeon owns her, so she kind of gets fucked over.
Hey, that's true. But she sold 40 million hair bows, each one going for $10 a pop.
Yeah, there we go.
In 2018 alone.
Does she always dress like that?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's what all these kids do, Josh. You got to get some fucked up look.
Bro, I got a great look right now. Barstool hoodie, jeans on. That's it. Oh, that's Samuel L. Jackson.
Bang. Bang. That's the first one that we both got together.
That's fuck. I think I'm going to say the right one, but I know. I think it's like Amigos. I don't really listen to Amigos. But
oh, is that one of Amigos?
I think it might be
Quavo.
I thought it was Kendrick Lamar.
No, that's definitely... Okay, I know that's not Kendrick Lamar.
Oh, wow.
I feel like Kendrick Lamar has like a flat top, doesn't he?
Oh, his brains. Yeah, okay. I have no clue, actually.
I think it's Quavo. All
right.
It's part of the Migos, though.
Take off.
Fuck! He's part of the Migos still.
I wouldn't have known. I don't listen to them. I thought Migos... I didn't even know that he individually had names.
There's three of them.
Yeah, go around. I do have a very cool three Migos... like t-shirt, and they're the Migos dressed as the three Amigos. Shout out. What is the company that does that? Unfortunate Portrait, based out of LA. Good company.
Right. Oh, that's... Oh,
wait.
That's the kid who won't come on this fucking podcast.
Do you know his name?
I know he's a wimp.
Noah Miller.
Noah Miller. Come on the podcast. Noah Miller. If you're going to talk shit, you should always come on the podcast. And by the way, I want to talk shit with you. Like, I want to pile on. I'm on his side.
I think you need to, you need to say that. He thought you were going to come on and, shit on him, but you want to team up with him.
Correct.
Yeah, so you got to make that known so he'll come on.
Well, that's because in the beginning, the people who cut the video cut it in a way where I'm not sure if he saw it, that, I'm on his side.
Yeah. Right, yeah. Also, TikTok Room likes to take little clips from our videos and cut them and leave certain parts out. So sometimes it makes us seem like we're not on people's side when we are.
Well, and no one can complain about that because I noticed the BFF accounts, and you actually had a funny line about this. They're just posting all your old shit, and you're like, am I going to have to hire my own guy here to go after Dave? Because it has been heavily weighted who's ever doing, which I think is you, Kareem. It seems like Josh gets most
up,
of the
Kareem?
Ricochet shots.
Where's Kareem? What the fuck's up, bud?
He's in here. He's in here.
What's going on? You got a problem with me or something?
No, I think you're just an easy target, and Dave's not really an easy target.
No, I'm kidding.
I have to see him every day, so... I just came at you. No. So maybe I'll sprinkle some Dave in there too.
I would love to see some Dave sprinkle. But yeah, I agree that those are all easy target videos. So
I've got a good picture in my arsenal of Dave. I'll post it sometime this week.
Perfect.
Cody Ko.
Wow.
Nice. Let's go.
Took three weeks, but you got it.
Nice try.
He's been looking at pictures of Cody Ko every night before he goes to bed to get that one.
I know what he's from. I don't fucking know his name.
No idea.
Seinfeld, Jason Alexander. So you don't watch Seinfeld ever? Never seen it?
Never seen it.
Huh.
Not once.
I hate Seinfeld.
Ugh. What do you mean you hate Seinfeld?
Seinfeld.
How do you hate Seinfeld?
It's stupid.
Your face is stupid. How do you hate Seinfeld?
I don't know her name.
It's Adriana Lima, isn't it?
Oh. It is.
I don't know that person's name.
I believe it's her. Yeah, Adriana Lima. Do you not know who that is, Josh?
I have no idea who that is.
One of the greatest models of all time. Supposedly, she was supposed to be sit. We went to Socialista in L.A. It's supposed to be this Cuban-style bar. Miami, right. Excuse me. Socialista Miami. And she was supposed to be sitting across from us, but I don't think she ever showed. I've also smelled her hair.
What?
Yeah, did a rundown way back in the day at the Super Bowl. And we're having guests. We're on this RV, tiny little RV. And we had guests coming in. She came in. She was squished on a couch with me, Big Cat, and Caleb. And I'm like, can I smell your hair? She's like, okay. I smelled it. It was beautiful. And then she told me never to do it again.
She was like, get me out of here.
Don't do that again.
Well, yeah, that's kind of weird, man.
It's a weird
move. Just trying to get content.
I get it.
Respect it. A guess do you have, Dave?
That's Thomas Petro. That's Thomas Petro from the Hype House. He's the ringleader at the Hype House.
He started it, right? Or founded it?
Yeah, I think so.
Honestly,
I'm pretty
sure
he did.
That's the lamest picture of all time. And I know the TikTok people do it and shit like that. But where are we as a society that men are taking that picture?
His nipples are really uneven, right? Or
I think they're just
no.
He's kind of
I think he's just
like Josh, honestly, where are we at?
With what?
This type of selfie.
Right. That guys do this now, you're saying?
Yeah, is that is it a mirror picture?
That's a mirror selfie, yeah. 100%.
Mirror pic.
Sad.
You're not a fan of the male mirror photo, eh?
No, I'm not. I don't know.
I get it.
I don't know.
I totally get
it. What about you, Brianna?
I've actually made a video saying that's a red flag. If a guy posts a mirror pic, it's unfollow.
But everyone does.
Guys.
Like Josh.
Yeah.
Guys. I've done it. I won't lie. But I didn't know it was that bad of a thing.
It is. It isn't, I guess. Everyone does it, but it's I don't
apparently
get it.
It is. It's making me feel weird looking at the fact that the photo's still up. Now I feel weird. I'm probably not going to take mirror photos as much.
Do you know that guy, by the way, Josh?
No, I know Thomas, yeah.
Are you guys friendly with the Hype House?
I don't know. I really don't fucking have any idea what the what goes on with that. I kind of just like removed myself from that situation. I just don't talk to him.
Like I'm not like out, against him. Are you guys like, hey, what's up?
Yeah. I would say that. I would say like, hey, what's up? Dap him up maybe. Give him a little, and then just walk away.
Got it.
Maybe take a mirror selfie with him. Take our shirts off really quick. Who knows? Oh, my God, dude. The fact that I'm not going to get this name. Fuck, man. It's right in my head.
Do you not know Brianna?
Tom Hanks.
He did. He did the movie, but the plane crashing. He did the movie, like, actually two planes crashing, didn't he? He did the one, like, in Chicago, the plane that crashed or something, and then the one in, what's the movie?
The Hudson.
He has Wilson, Castaway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're not saying his number one movie, by the way, by a mile, but Forrest Gump.
Yeah, that one too. Fuck, there's an H in there, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Tom Hanks?
Yeah, Tom Hanks.
Fuck yeah, let's go. I don't know why I couldn't remember that. I just watched Forrest Gump for the first time like 3 weeks ago, maybe a month ago.
Great movie.
Yeah, awesome movie.
Oh, I think you're going to know this, actually. Because he spans. He has reasons to be relevant for me and you.
I couldn't even
guess. I don't got a name to guess.
You know his daughter.
Okay, so it's a Jose Canseco or whatever the guy's name
Jose
is.
Jose Canseco.
Who's daughter, that?
So he was like an unbelievable baseball player during my era, but his daughter, Josie Canseco, is like
so how
in
you feel
his
about
world.
The shirt?
Oh.
How you feel about the shirt though?
Yeah, that's Jose.
That's kind of like that's almost worse than a mirror selfie, I think. That shirt.
80s, just like Miami, just Jose like juicing up, just doing it.
Nipples.
Have
nipples
you ever met his daughter?
Out. Yeah, a couple times.
She seems like stunning looking.
She is a beautiful girl, yeah.
Who's she dating now? Somebody girl. Famous?
No. Her and Logan just broke up. He had beef with Logan about it.
Right.
He tweeted at it was I'm gonna be honest, Logan had probably the craziest like comeback I've ever seen, but he talked about how he wanted to fight Logan. And then Logan was like, I got no problem smashing it, whatever
another
the guy's last name is.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah. He's just like, I love smashing. And I was like, wow.
She dated Mike Studd, too.
Okay, yeah, the rapper.
Yep.
He also played baseball, right? Mike Studd?
Yeah, he did. I also made a rap video with him.
You did?
Yeah, I did.
That's hard.
Yep. Rise Studd, Pages, I listened Rise to, like, was produced by Mike Studd. He gave me like the beat and we went in the studio and just put the thing together. Then we went out to a club after it was made and requested to be turned on and just like smoked.
Monster Hits only though?
Yeah, it was Monster Hits only.
Jeez. Is that Paris Hilton?
Yes. Good.
That's fucking, it's because she DM'd me. She's in my DM.
Shut up.
What'd she
say?
No,
I'm kidding. But we do DM. We have DM'd, yeah.
What?
Let's see. I think it was about a podcast thing. I think it was when I was doing that podcast with Noah at that one point when we were doing like a movie podcast or something like that. We talked to her. Yep, that's what it was. I saw she was following me. She followed me out of nowhere.
That's fucking like, big time.
She follows a lot of TikTokers. She's like,
yeah. Smart.
Yeah.
She's good for rich. Paris. We should get Paris on this show.
We probably could.
That'd be sweet.
Just fucking do it. I did a pizza review with her. Can you DM her right in live time? Be like, hey, Paris, I do a podcast with Dave Porn. You ate pizza. You probably don't remember, but like, we'd love you on this podcast.
Yeah, I'll DM her.
Love it. All right, so that's Boomer Zoomer. We have anything else on this New Year's resolution show?
Yeah, we got to do some questions.
Oh, yes, of course.
The Ask BFFs questions. And for everybody listening, you guys can ask Dave and Josh questions on TikTok using the hashtag AskBFFs. Okay, so we have a couple of questions this week. First one, where do you guys see BFFs going in 2021?
Do you want to go first?
Sure. I think that there's going to be like a lot more content. I feel like we have to go in a direction where like more content's going to be made around it, or I just think it will naturally, especially with like the vaccines and everything coming out, and like we're probably going to actually be in person more. So I think like more in-person content for the show, merch coming, obviously all that. I think it's just getting bigger and bigger.
But. Yeah, I agree. We've gone over it. I think the sky's the limit. I always judge how people approach me and I'm getting a lot of BFF stuff when I'm just out. People like love the podcast. They're following it. And we agree. We're talking. Excuse me. I want to get out LA. He's going to come to New York. Hopefully vaccine's gone. The merch is done. We got to talk about it. That's so fire. But we only have 500 pieces of it. So they're going to go out in like 1 second.
No, like they're actually, they're going to be gone in a few hours or like a day. Like it's not going to last longer than a day. There's no way that much.
Day. I think we'll sell out instantly. So we'll just talk about how we want to do that.
Fuck yeah.
All right. Next question. Do you want to mend any relationships in 2021?
I wouldn't mind mending with Bryce Hall because it's fucking up this show a little bit. Like, we want to get Sway Boys on and, like, talk and bust balls. And, you know.
Right.
I don't care. So I wouldn't mind him just being like, you know what? I was a baby. And I'll just be like, I accept you being a baby and let's move past it.
Okay. I would say I don't really feel like I need to make up with anyone.
Yeah, you have no beef with anybody.
I'm not really, like. Just for some reason, I used to get into beef with people like every other month. There was like a new person I had beef with, but just no one's really like done anything online to make me say like, fuck you to them.
I have a question for you. Not to keep bringing up Bryce. I know you don't want to talk about it because he's your boy. And then they're like, why don't you defend him? And you do defend him. So it's all on me. But we were out and we met a girl and she's like, I fucking hate Bryce Hall too. I'm like, yeah. It's like, well, he like beat up my friend at a party, whatever it was. And it was like he punched him in the face or something. Will Bryce Hall punch me?
No.
All right, good.
I don't think he's like that. Bryce isn't going to just like, people try to make it seem like he's going to fight for no reason. That would never happen.
Okay, good. Because I don't fight. I've never thrown a punch in my life. I don't want to get like punched by like a kid half my age.
I've never seen him do anything. Embarrassing. I've never seen him do anything physical that wasn't like the person kind of deserved it.
Okay.
Like they
he
went
may
too
be
far.
Like he's kind of talking all the shit, so I just popped them. Whatever.
All right. Next question.
Do a boxing match.
What bad habit do you want to break in 2021? Last question. Any bad habits you guys have?
I mean, I don't want to be cliche, but I got to start working out. I mean, I'm getting fat just eating, doing nothing.
You need the sway gains?
Yeah. Maybe
that could be
there.
Content. He could easy hook you up. You guys could work out together.
Get a huge lift program going. I would say bad habits. I don't really do that. I don't really give up bad habits for New Year's. It's like I don't really care that much. I don't have a lot of bad things that I do, I don't think. I'm 18.
I have a lot of bad habits.
Me too.
I probably do too, but I'm 18, so I don't really mind having them.
I got a lot of bad habits.
Yeah, that's the last question.
All right. So that's the first episode. BFF's back in new year. And hopefully we can start going out. Vaccine comes out. We can get all this shit together.
Hell yeah.
And take this thing to the moon. So subscribe, watch it. We have both the YouTube version, the podcast version. And that's that.
See everyone next week.
All right. Later.
Peace.